thank you very much, Dr. Golson. I am finally into the Christmas season now. I'm ready. I know all of you are. 2 days, but who's counting? And it's coming very, very soon. How many have exams yet today? Just today, do you have exams today? All right. Okay. How many have four left still? Ooh, okay. There's still a few like that. Well, it's coming, and it's a lot to do in the next few days. As you know, those veteran students, this is a historic message that I give every time you're about to go, and I don't make any apology for it. In fact, you probably can give my message along with me, and that's fine. That's no problem. By the way, in Dombach and in Steele, from 10:30 to 11:30, there's sort of a refreshment time for you. So if you are in that area and you want to grab some refreshments, that's just available for you. So hopefully that'll be a good thing. You don't have to go over to Cathcart or whatever, but you certainly can for lunch if you want to. But if you want to grab a snack, it's available there in the lobby of Steele and in Dombach. Well, you know, many of you, the majority of you, this will be a really short chapel. But for the seniors, I'm sorry, we got to keep you the whole time. We got some, and this—that's I'm not kidding. We have to keep you the whole time because we have some a survey we need you to do for us, actually for our accreditation process. I do apologize about that, but for those of you who are going to be the beneficiaries of the short chapel, I guess it's a positive for you. My challenge to you, as always, and you can do along with me, it's a STAR challenge. What's the S stand for? Not safety. But safety's good. Not seatbelt, no. All right. Service, no. Obviously, you have not listened to my message in the past, all right? Speed, all right? Speed, yes, thank you. Speed. And it's don't do it. That's what I, don't speed, all right? And please be careful. I am very, very, it's tongue-in-cheek, but I am very, very serious. God has been so gracious to us over the past, in pretty much the entire history of Clearwater Christian College. He's given us incredible protection, especially given where we are and the traffic that we have to deal with every day around here. And I want to praise his name for that. I mean, it is a gift from him. But please, let's not presume on him, all right? Be careful when you're driving home. Be careful. Keep it under control. The fact that you get home an hour earlier or whatever, to risk your life or risk the lives of those in your car, it just isn't worth it, okay? So please be careful. Think about it, and I think that'll be very, very helpful for you. We will be praying for you, I promise you, all right? We pray with fervor. We will pray with fervor about your going home. We realize there are thousands of miles being traveled. All right, how many of you flying? Can I see your hands? Flying? Driving? Okay, about half and half there. So please be careful as you're driving. So that's number one. Number two is time. Take time with your family. They haven't seen you for a while. And could I challenge you? I know what you want to do. The first thing you want to do when you get home is to say, sleep. Sleep till 2 o'clock in the afternoon. All right? And then get up, eat, and go back to bed. All right? You know, I know. All right? Now, may I just give you the perspective of a parent for just a second? They would really like to see you. They would really like to talk to you. And their schedule is not your schedule necessarily. All right? So be thoughtful about that. Spend time. And there's two things. Spend time, of course, with your family, with your friends. I mean, make a special effort to spend time with your family. Some of you, that will not be a big deal at all. You will absolutely love to. Some of you, it's harder. You don't get along as well. I understand that. But you can make a huge difference. You can say make a huge statement to your family by the time that you're willing to spend with them. And of course, some of you have been holding on for dear life with respect to your devotions and all of that. And that's kind of been getting not a whole bunch of activity this semester. May I beg of you to spend time with your Lord? Really, really spend time with Him. And make that a huge priority to you. Spend time with your family and, of course, spend time with your Lord. The A in STAR, that's speed, time, and A is availability. And what I mean by that, being available, is specifically in your church, in your churches back home, go to your pastor, go to your youth pastor, tell them you're there for a few weeks. How can that person use you in the youth group or in an outreach ministry or something where you can be used in that church ministry? Go to them and ask them. And I guarantee you, they will put you to work. So be careful what you ask for, all right? Because when you ask, they will respond. And that is a great thing that you're doing. You're talking, you're assessing and letting people see what God is doing in your life. And when you come back, what you're doing is you're representing Jesus Christ and what He's done in your life the last several weeks. And I hope He has done a whole bunch in your life. And that leads me to the R in STAR, and that is recharge. There's two points to the recharge portion of the message. One, recharge physically. That's the sleep part. You know, I think you got that one down. All right? You understand that part. And I'm seeing you do need to do that. I know that. But part of recharge, that's the rest. But part of recharge is also assessing, how did it go this semester? How did it go with you this semester? In other words, when you look at yourself today, December the 15th, and you look back at August, the end of August, middle to the end of August when you came, what's happened to you spiritually? What's going on in your life since August to now? Some of you, you've grown like crazy. Some of you have just been gobbling up everything you can get about God and His Word. And being in a Christian atmosphere, especially those of you coming from public schools, you say, wow, I've never been in any place like this. And some of you have been struggling spiritually, and you know that. Really take time and assess what's going on in your life and in your heart. What's happened to you in the last 3 months? Have you gotten cold towards spiritual things? Is that what's happened? Then this has not been a successful semester for you. If that's what's happened, if listening to God's Word is drudgery for you, then I'm going to say it hasn't been successful for you. So take time. Really be honest with you and God. Say, God, what is really going on in my life, in my heart, spiritually? And have I been growing this semester? For many of you, you have. Great. Keep going. Keep walking with Him. That is a great thing. In 2 Corinthians, I just want to leave you with this passage in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, beginning with verse 11. It's a strong verse to start out with, but it's a great set of verses here. And if I could use it as my challenge, I will do that. Verse 11 says, "Knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. We are made manifest unto God, and I trust also are made manifest in your consciences. For we commend not ourselves again unto you, but give you occasion to glory on our behalf, that ye may have somewhat to answer them which glory in appearance and not in heart. For whether we be beside ourselves, whether we're crazy, it is to God. Whether we be sober, whether we're in our right minds, it is for your cause." Verse 14, "For the love of Christ constrains us, because we thus judge that if one died for all, then we're all dead. And that he died for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto him which died for them and rose again. May I beg of you, for the love of Christ, to control your actions, your attitudes, your hearts during this Christmas time. That's what it's about. That's what Clearwater Christian College is about. It's the love of Christ. And I hope that you will be able to shed that abroad when you get home. Last thing I want to do is, if I could get the ones that Dr. Golson was talking about, those of you who are graduating as of December, will you come on up here and join me up here? And as we close in prayer, I'd like you to be a part. So please, come on up. Wait just a second here. There's a few more than this, but we'll hold on just one second. May I first of all say congratulations on a job well done. Way to go. We're very, very proud of you. We're going to miss you next semester, but we're very, very glad that God has brought you through to the end of a big journey, a long journey. And I trust that he will continue to bless you as you go forward. And God has all sorts of things in store for you. And hopefully we'll see you at graduation time. But it is sad that we won't have you here next semester. I think they deserve a round of applause. That's for sure. All right. I'm going to close us in prayer. Would you please, as we did yesterday, if those of you who are freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, will you grab your chairs, put them back there? Seniors, if you'll, you can just stay right where you are. We're going to have stuff for you. We'll try to make this as fast as possible as soon as we pray. So freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, if you will immediately grab your chairs and head back to the back. Seniors, if you'll hang around. And we'll try to get this done as fast as possible, all right? Let's pray together. Father, I pray for these young people who are seated before me, who are facing this Christmas vacation. Got some exams before that, so I pray you should help them with those. But I pray specifically for this break time. I pray that you will give them a God-centered vacation. I pray that you will keep their minds, their hearts centered on you. Help them to follow hard after you. I pray that you will give them an understanding of who you are, who they are, and that you are a great God, and that we really, really need you. We desperately need your power to live for Christ. There's no way that we can do it on our own. So, Spirit, will you work? Will you just help us? We sometimes don't even know how to pray about that, but would you help us to live for you? And Father, I pray for these standing beside me. They've accomplished much, and now they're headed out. We're going to miss them. Thank you for their accomplishment. Thank you for how hard they have worked, for bringing them to this point. Lord, I pray that you'll give them a great semester, next semester, and some of them entering into full-time positions and other graduate school internships, all sorts of things. Lord, I pray your blessing upon them. Lord, I ask that you will use them. Use them in many different ways, but help them to follow hard after you. I pray that what they've learned here and what they've learned in their churches would just fill them. And Holy Spirit, that you will use them. Lord, we thank you so much for them. Would your blessing be upon them? We thank you. Father, would you bless in the remaining days of this semester and the exams, help these young people to finish well, help them to maintain their integrity in the process. We praise you for them. In Jesus' name, amen. are dismissed.